Even though I have quite some experience working on the Masterclass series, I must confess that this new project was a bit puzzling for me. Of course, one of Carson's main threats is his positional play, his strategic vision, so I could feel favored by dealing with this section. But at the same time, a natural question popped up. Do I really understand what Carson does, how he is thinking? Does anybody understand this? I mean, if his opponent would guess his way of thinking, then he would be not so successful. He would not be dominating the whole era so clearly. So after some thought, I just decided to present the facts as they are, and not really trying to understand them until their deep end, because maybe this is by now still impossible. Maybe Carson could explain the way he's thinking, but he would not, because why would he disclose his secrets? But maybe not even he could do that very clearly, because maybe it's just a talent which you cannot explain. So what would I first of all notice in Carson's style? His plans, his strategic plans, are frequently very, very mysterious, especially in dual positions where nothing seems to be happening. He has some mysterious regrouping. Okay, they look logical, but at the same time, it's not very clear if they are going to bring some fruit. And then while the fight goes on and the opponent also has to make decisions, there comes a moment when some concrete things start happening, and then suddenly you realize that Carson's pieces were placed on the right squares, and then the rest becomes obvious. So I would just agree with Judith Polgar when she said that Carlsen sees farther ahead than any of his opponents of today. In which he does this, hard to explain. I also believe that when designing his strategic plans, Carlsen has full confidence, not only in himself, because many players have this, but also in his plans and in the fact that the future will turn to his favor. So this consequence in carrying out the plans, even though it's not yet obvious if they are they'll be successful or not, it's quite important in a practical fight. I also have the feeling that he has the freedom of doing on board what he wants, what he feels. I mean, he's not. This, of course, the feeling when looking at his games. He takes many original decisions strategically. Okay, if he feels this way, he just goes for it. And it's not a little thing to listen to your interior ego. There are also some games in which he's. His play is so clear-cut that it gives the impression of perfection. But sometimes there are some psychological aspects involved, and he sometimes kind of bluffs or makes some concessions just to bring the game into a territory which he's very familiar with. Much has been said, especially in the period before he became a world champion, that Carlsen's wins were many times lucky, that he managed to turn tables around in desperate or just lost positions. And to a certain extent, this is true. But I have, in the last video, I have try to explain that luck is not does not exist as such. You have to provoke it somehow. It also has to do somehow with the aspects I mentioned before, because it's a practical game, and if the man knows his plan and sticks to it consequently, even though he may be lost in the practical game, it doesn't take much for the opponent to slip from the winning to an equal and then a worse position. Actually, Kramnik was somehow sarcastically saying that, well, he doesn't know why, but Carlsen's opponents always play weaker against him than they do usually. Well, of course, it depends. It may be an objective truth, but it may again have something to do with all what I said before. So. It's also a matter of luck. If your play induces hits on the opponent's hidden weaknesses, then okay, maybe it's luck, maybe it's not. I'm not really sure to whom I would compare Carlsen. Some compare with him with Capablanca and Karpov, maybe because his outstanding endgame technique. But okay, this is not the endgame section, so. I will not insist. I think that he has a style of his own, and if I would compare him with somebody, this would be Fischer. But not because there is some similarity in their play, for some external factors. Fischer also liked to play until the end. He didn't agree to a draw or didn't resign until he felt that all the possibilities were exhausted. And the same applies to Carlsen. And he was also very, okay, somehow fanatic about chess. It was obvious that he was very much in the game. So this is how he could give the best of out of himself. So that's more or less the map of this section. And now I invite you to see the game videos in which I have tried to highlight the aspects mentioned above.